man's shot to death.
I wonder what he'd done.
Well, whatever it was, somebody didn't like it, that's for sure.
Help me, boys. Save me. Hide me. Don't take too damn long about it, because I'm going fast.
We can get in terrible trouble. He's right, you know, ain't none of our business. But if we don't do something, he's bound to die.
That's right, Sonny. I'm on my way to meet my maker. And I ain't ready for him.
I don't want to touch him.
Is this your farm?
Yes, I own it.
Did you see anybody unfamiliar pass this way yesterday or today?
No, I've seen nobody.
You, boy?
No, sir.
Well, we got a mean one loose. Watch out for it.
Kindly ride clear of my flower bed.
Watch the geraniums, boys.
One, two, three. All here and accounted for. Good evening, boys.
Evening.
There. It's nice to see you. I've been sitting up here all day staring down our cows behind while I'm sick. Oh, what's in the pan tonight?
Rabbit.
Hey, that'll slip right down. Your ma sure knows what to do with a rabbit.
My mom's dead. I cooked it.
Oh. I got something for you, too.
$4 in there. Did you save it, or did you lift it?
I saved it.
You're gonna need it, mister. We were through your pockets and you ain't got nothing in it.
I got a money belt, boys, underneath my pants. With over $1,000 of gold. You better save this for a rainy day. Oh, I noticed some lace on this bandage. Whose petticoat did it come off of, and was the lady still in it when you took it?
No, it's just curtains from my attic.
Well, what do I owe you, boys?
How do you mean?
Food, keep, patchwork, how much?
We didn't figure to charge you, mister.
Well, you could get plenty. There's a price on my head, boys. $500 in Texas, $600 in Oklahoma, and $1,000 in Arkansas.
Who are you, mister?
The name's Spikes. Harry Spikes. I'm a bank robber, boys.
A bank robber?
That's right, sonny. That's how I got my ass shot up this time, and 20 times before.
If they caught you, would they hang you?
No. They'd cut off my head and stick it on a telegraph pole as a warning. Like they'd done to a couple of friends of mine.
Well, then how come you stick with it?
Well, I got 5 Mexican ladies waiting for me in 5 different towns. I got a dozen shirts, all handmade out of pure silk. Every color of the rainbow. And leather in my boots is as soft as butter. That's because Indian ladies chew them before they saw them. I got bonded bourbon whiskey and a box of Havana cigars by my bed every time I lay my head down. And that's only when things are slack.
But you're sleeping on a hay bale now.
Nothing's perfect. Well, boys, come tomorrow. I'll be gone. So it's time I made my manners. You got my eternal and everlasting gratitude. I know that ain't much in the light of what you've done for me. But you remember this. Harry Spikes, your man. I owe you. Anytime. Any place. And anywhere. I didn't see your horse stable.
I didn't put him in it, I.
No, why is that?
I forgot.
Mine was on other things?
I guess.
It's your responsibility. If you finish your supper, we'll go look for him.
No, I can do it.
We'll go together. He's wandered off. Did you tether him?
Yes.
Now maybe he slipped loose. Call to him. Why don't you call? There's no sign of him. Is it possible he was stolen?
I don't know.
I think you do know. I'll ask you for a second time. Where's your horse?
He's mine. I worked for him. I earned him.
I'm not questioning that. You work to the limit of your strength and you don't complain. But there are other things in your character that grieve me. You disobey. You resist me. You're not open with me. Now, where's your horse?
I gave him to somebody.
Was it that fugitive? That thief? That murderer?
Yes. Yes, I did.
Oh, you lied. And the posse and to me. And you stole clothing and food. You understand what you've done? You see yourself as I see you, revealed in every sin of which you're capable? You've tried my sufferance and God's.
Who comes first, Father?
just up and left?
That's right. I took the last licking I can take without killing him.
You got any back left?
Nah, he didn't eat much.
What do you do?
I don't know. I'll turn up something or other.
You ain't never been any further than the next town.
The world don't end there.
Suppose it don't. You know, I wouldn't mind going with you. My daddy's mistook me for a mule for some time now.
Well, I'll write you as soon as I like someplace.
It's gonna be kind of lonesome around here.
Don't back in any pitchforks.
Don't roll out of bed.
Goodbye.
You mean you're really going for good? I won't be back this way again. Wish I was coming.
No, you better not get mixed up in it.
You were gonna teach me to swim this summer.
Well, just hold your nose and jump off the bank.
Always been together.
You. What are you up to?
Why should you have all the fun?
I just assumed you were both of you were at.
Did you bring clean underwear?
Nope. Gonna let this one set ripen.
Okay, we'll do it. We'll throw them together. And by God, the one thing we won't ever do is kiss no man's boot.
You bet! Yeah!
Let's go get lucky!
Wait a minute, wait a minute. Where are we going?
Hell, I don't know. Anywhere!
If we could do you some chores in exchange for a dollar. Spool your pigs, clean out your barn, whatever. You say.
You can scat. I don't hire saddle traps. Ain't you heard, lady? Money's like manure. It's only good when you spread it around.
There's lunch.
No, I ain't come to that just yet.
You always was a finicky eater, Will.
What you're doing is a terrible sin. You're eating the body and the blood of Christ.
Todd, tonight this ain't nothing but crackers and elderberry wine.
Gonna be breakfast?
It's breakfast, lunch, and supper.
I sure am hungry.
Well, drink some more. It'll fill you up.
Haven't we got a dime between us?
No, not one.
Money don't even know we're alive.
You could sell your watch.
Is Daddy getting that watch?
Yeah, but it's solid gold. It'd bring a fistful of money. Come on, don't you want to sit down in front of a plate again?
Don't you understand nothing? He don't want to let that go.
Hey, you. Get up. You ain't from around here. I know you ain't, because I know every man, dog, and mule 50 miles.
That's a wide acquaintance.
You're a pretty funny boy. Where you from?
Down the road a piece.
Down the road a piece, huh? Boys, if there's one thing riles my ass, the sight of three high smelling down at the used egg suckers on these quiet streets. Now, what's your business here? And don't get a fresh answer.
We're just passing through.
You sure are. I reckon 5 minutes will be about right.
5 minutes from when?
5 minutes from the time you got into town.
Well, we might need 10.
Well, my friend here has to use public convenience.
Don't ask me, you little bastard.
You can call me that, mister, are you?
You get going.
Friendly folks around here.
We better move on, like you said.
Move where? On what? We're broke.
Mr. Spikes is never broke. He's never hungry either.
What made you think of him all of a sudden?
Looking at that bank. You know what he'd do if he was in our shoes? He'd walk in that bank, pull out his gun and say, it's all baloney, so slice me some.
That's stealing.
It's better than starving.
Safe. It works on a time clock.
Well, how long before it goes off?
9 o'clock.
I'll wait for it.
What's the matter with you? You gone crazy?
Maybe.
Come on, let's get out of here. That sheriff's 2 steps away.
We two go if you want to, but I'm staying put.
Let go of it, Will. This is deep water.
I'm going to Ohio.
All right, if you're going to be in trouble, I guess I'm going to be in trouble.
It's 9 o'clock, mister.
That clock could be a mite fast.
And you could be lying.
It's gonna go off any second. Don't get excited, son. Any second now.
It better, mister.
There's still time, son.
For what?
To think what you're doing. To think where it'll get you.
I've set the house on fire. Let us smoke.
Todd, get beside the door in case somebody comes in. Let's.
You can put your hands down.
Hey, Bobby Ray, you seen anything of 3 young desert rats?
Yeah, I've seen them.
Damnation! Boy, you're gonna have me hunting you down for this till the day you die.
Stuck your cap in his mouth, Todd, and shut him up.
Can you open up? Open wide. Now get back. Get back.
Don't hurry out of here. We'd like a little jump.
What are you up to? What are you doing here? Hey!
They're gonna be on us. Hurry up! Across the Rio Grande. I think we're in Mexico.
Look here. Bullet took a lock of hair off me right behind my ear.
I got blood on my shirt.
That man fell against you.
got hold of me around my neck. I never killed nothing in my whole life. I never even killed a rabbit.
Todd, it was an accident.
It doesn't matter. He's dead. To God and to all of God's world forever. I ought to go back and give myself up. I'm the one that did it.
Well, if we got an answer, we'll all answer together.
Join up with the army.
Well, I wouldn't look the other way just because we come in to join up.
Well, at least they feed you three times a day. I heard the railroad pays good wages for laying line.
It wouldn't take you if you ain't Chinese. Anyway, what's back on the other side?
What are we gonna do then? Will sides run?
I don't know. We'll light on something.
Well, one thing for sure. I can't die any more than I started. Guess he's living over yesterday.
I wish we had it back again.
Our pockets is just as empty as our bellies. No. No tango dinero. Todd! Todd! Get back. Give him some air. It ain't nothing serious. He's just hollow.
Timepiece. He gave it to me on his deathbed. It's 18 karat gold, and it ain't lost a minute in 30 years. Now, how much are you gonna give me for it?
100.
Dollars or pesos?
Pesos, senor.
Well, any but $10.
Si, senor.
Mister, I robbed a bank. I'm still not as big a bandit as you. I don't know why I'm still friends when I'm probably in this breath.
You better choke up. My neck lasts for a while. And it isn't so bad, really, if you don't get your nose too close.
Catholics and asked to see a priest. Maybe he'd help us out.
No.
Catholic can smile at a Baptist right off. Then they won't have nothing to do with them. Yeah, they got a big church on, all right. Did you ever notice when they open that big door, the altar piece they got over there is made of gold? We was just about cooked. Me with running sores, and him with dysentery, and him with ticks eating him alive.
Well, how'd you ever get us loose, Mr. Spikes?
Why, I rolled $100 bill around a good cigar and put another one in my handshake.
I don't know how I'll ever repay
it. I'll get you in a poker game someday, but meanwhile, boys, you'll be better coming after a bath. So, you went and robbed yourself a bank, did you? Killed a man and lost the money. Don't look like you boys got the gift for it.
Well, I guess it's done and it can't be undone.
No way I know, huh? Hell, 2 days after they buried the man, the Louisville Courier-Gazette wrote a poem about you boys. Had 15 verses. Read like this. Three country boys, each one a knave, slew a state senator and sent him to his grave. Sold a lot of papers.
That man we killed was a state senator?
That's right, son. Friend to widows and orphans. You brought down a big one, boys. There's a bounty on it. They don't care whether you're cold or warm. They'll pay $1,500 for each one of you.
That makes us sitting ducks, don't it? Not knowing which way we're going to get flushed.
That's the game.
We sure didn't mean nothing like this to come of it. We didn't desire to commit murder. It just kind of ran away from us.
Well, we all started out something else. Way back.
What would you do if you was us, Mr. Spikes?
Lie close. Keep your boots by your bed. Sit up quick when a dog barks. Go out a little. Make no acquaintances. Have nothing peculiar about your manner or address. And above all, never talk. It's the talking man gets caught. Don't look so scared, boys. Now look at me. What did you? Northfield. Jonesboro. Elysian Township. Marysville. Galton. Oh, I ducked late a few times, but I'm still standing. The thing to do, my friends, is submit to your fate with Christian resignation and live bravely to your appointed time. Don't worry, sir. Now, bring the boys whatever you got left. It's fat and juicy. If you don't have anything cooked, bring them a hind quarter raw.
I'd like you to keep track of what you spend on this spike. We'll make good on it as soon as we can.
And don't worry about it. I'll carry it for a while. Well, you boys left the farm and you had some trouble. You've seen some of the world. How do you find it?
We ain't really seen that much of it. Just been chased through it.
Well, you're still better off than most people. Most people are tied to one thing in one place. They eat, work, and die doing it. And don't seem to bother. But I say, break off a big round. Come with me.
You, Jackson.
You damn fool. I don't even know you.
Jesus Christ.
I thought you were someone else.
He's been looking for somebody all night.
Well, he's found him.
No, sir, it's just a mistake. I'll let him off. He's dead drunk. Hell, we just come down from Eagle Pass to have us a good time.
I'm middle-aged and I'm tired of fools. Make sure the next time. Let's go.
Don't you think we ought to find you a doctor?
I doctor myself. This'll scab up my mind. Feels like I walked through barbed wire. That whiskey-soaked son of a bitch.
I thought you were gonna kill him.
Did you, son? Well, I'm more careful than you think.
Muerte. 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 Muerte.
Why the hell should I pay good money for it? I'll get it free one of these days. I'm going to a whorehouse now, boys, to take my mind off my aches and pains, so I'm sending you to bed. Now, here's $1 apiece. Get yourself a room at the Grand National Hotel on the second floor. The cockroaches don't crawl that high.
Them cowboys are still in town. Maybe we should stick with him for a while.
I don't think he'd like that.
Well, he doesn't have to see us.
Good morning, boys.
What is this, Tyke?
Why?
You were up pretty early.
Yes, sir.
You just got in?
No, we've been sleeping here most of the night.
Oh?
Well, we was a little worried about those cowboys from Eagle Pass.
Is that right?
Well, there was 10 of them.
Well, I thank you for keeping an eye out. Come on, I'll buy you breakfast. You can go down any time, Miss Disney. Could be a man in a nice broadcloth coat just stepping off a train, picking cherries off a tree, tipping his hat and bidding good morning to you. Any one of them can have your ticket. This is the mayor and his wife. Talk to me, but I nod to him. Well, young gentlemen, it's time for me to say adios. You're out of jail and your bellies are full. You did me a good turn once, and I'm not ungrateful. I've enjoyed your company. I hope you can say the same for me.
Won't we be seeing you again, Mr. Spikes?
Not likely. I have business to attend to. This is goodbye.
Well, we sure do appreciate everything you've done for us.
Take care of yourself, Mr. Spikes. Don't roll out of bed.
He sure was friendly.
Yeah, he sure was.
Why,
hello there, Mr. Spikes.
It smells of garbage in there.
Yes, sir, it does.
You settled on dishwashing for your life's work.
No, this is our last day here. The lady told us not to come back.
Yeah, we busted a few too many of your plates.
What you done lined up next?
Well, we figured to hire on to dig holes.
That's what prairie dogs do.
Won't Santa go without supper?
Take off those damn aprons and come along. Saloon down the street. But you got some spirit. You got some craw. Where I come from, you harness a mule. But you give a horse a chance to run. How would you boys like to throw in with me?
It means goodbye to our folks and our home and all that.
Yeah, but it's that way now, Tom. But one thing for sure, we'd get noticed.
We'll come with you, Mr. Spice. Thanks very much.
Good. Now let's see if you can shoot.
Stiff. I don't think I can do anything except sit bolt upright in a chair.
The ladies in this town are going to whinny, prance, and kick just at the sight of you three. Doctor that took out my appendix with only a quart and a half of tequila. Now, what do you think, boys? Solid gold. Now, the side door is about 35 feet from the front door. Les, you'll come in this way. Me and Will go in through the front. Now, once inside, the teller stands here, and generally the guard over here. They've got gold brick, but it's too heavy for the horses, so they'll leave it. They keep the money in the vault back here, but they've got some cash in the drawer up front. But while it ain't generally much, we'll take it because it'll aid the cause.
Well, then they just don't want to give it to us.
Then they're dead men for sure. Remember, boys, there's no arrest or trial for this crime. Only convictions. Now, Todd, we can't have you standing around outside with them gentlemen unemployed hauling a bunch of horses. So 4 minutes after we leave, you take off with the horses, and you'll meet us just as we're coming out. You got the watch?
Yes.
Good. Now, I know you boys will be plucky and do your job.
Hey, I'll be on time.
Let's give it a try.
Take that bank?
Why no, boys. I keep my own money in that bank.
Hey,
understand a bit of that, Mr. Spikes.
Well, I could cook. I learned from my wife.
He was married?
Oh, yes. To a wonderful lady. Let's fool with each other. She could talk in French. She played the piano. She sang in a fine and sweet voice.
You don't say.
That lady made a man out of me. She taught me everything. How to read and write. How to pull up to a table. How to use a spoon and a fork. I love that woman.
What become of her, Mr. Spikes?
I killed her. Another man's bed. Sit here before me. Wilson?
Yes, Paul.
You ran off from home.
Yes, sir.
Why did you go away?
One thing leads to another, Father.
You've broken the law. You've corrupted and tainted our blood.
I'm doing the best I can with what I've got.
How will it end?
I don't know. Something's bound to happen. Something's bound to.
How can I call you my son any longer? How can I acknowledge you?
Wait.
You'll be cold. You're cold now.
Wait.
Back in the U.S. about 2 miles down. Now, Uvalde's a dandy little town. The bank there's got lots of money. An easy place to get away from, too.
Don't I have a share?
Well, sure. An old one. And he's got a deputy that's even older. Two old men just gumming their food. Why, we'll open up that bank like a can of peaches.
Dog!
Hey. You know, when I first met you boys, you were a sober bunch. There's no mischief in you. No daydreaming. Nothing but old before your time.
Well, you make the music, Mr. Spikes, and we'll dance to it.
Well, there she is, boys, just down the street from the bridge. The Cattleman's Bank of Uvalde.
How much money do you think I got in there, Mr. Spikes?
I was there myself, and Mr. J.P. Calhoun deposited 20,000 in species. That'll buy you a haircut and a shave, son.
Why don't we just go on in and clean it out right now, Mr. Spikes?
We'll wait till Saturday. They'll have more money then. That's when we open the vault for payday. Show a little patience, boys. We'll make camp, and I'll go in tonight and scout around a little. See how it all lays out.
You think that bank's gonna be hot work?
I guess we're putting our heads in the lion's mouth, all right. I just hope we can take it out again.
You got any kind of religion, Les?
I always sort of thought of old Johnny God as being a big, bald-headed man with whiskers and a temper. How about you?
Man, if there's a hell, I'd like to keep out of it.
What you got there?
It's a letter. If anything happens, I want one of you two to see that my mom gets it.
What are you saying?
Dear Ma, I'm getting along fine, eating good and sleeping good. I've took up with good company, and every day has something new in it. I'm leading a different kind of life than I led at home, with plenty of excitement and adventure, which appeals to me. Every nickel I make is clear gain. The reason I'm writing this letter is I'm going into a desperate enterprise in a day or two. If you don't think I've been a good son, I'm sorry for it. Tell that to Pa, too.
I hope Sissy is growing up and all right. Goodbye, Mama, if I never see you again.
How come you boys ain't looking lively? How come you don't post a guard? While you're sitting here by the fire, toasting your toes, anybody could walk right in and plant a big, juicy kiss on your cheek.
Or send you off to a long sleep.
Guess it was kind of dumb.
Live and learn. Things is quieting down. They ain't expecting a wild bunch like us. Now, you boys don't drink. And you don't smoke. So I brought you a bag of cinnamon buns. A pretty widow makes them. Now I'm gonna get myself drunk. If I can just get my head empty, then the true answers come to me. I'd appreciate it if you compose me for sleep. Take off my boots when you think I'm ready. I'll say goodnight, boys. We're being watched.
What?
Somebody's up there looking down. Stay with your car.
Who do you think it is?
No idea.
Hello down there!
Well, come on down. We got coffee.
I hope it's fresh cooked.
But you got a cinnamon bun to go with this?
This ain't no restaurant, old fellow. Where you from?
Just from town.
What town would that be?
Why, you Valley? Didn't know there's any others around.
Well, we wouldn't know. We're just riding through.
Pretty big slug of ashes, just for one campfire.
What's your name?
Oh, got a lot of names. Billy Blanco, Kid White, take your pick.
Oh, I've heard of you. You put a few in Boot Hill, haven't you?
Two or three rows.
Took some from behind, I heard.
That's right, brother, that's the way they was facing.
What do you want of us?
A warning.
We ain't got nothing worrying.
Oh, shit, Harry. I spotted you in town. Then I come out here and I see these three pups. Damned if they ain't wanted for killing the senator in Carrizo Springs.
So?
So I figure you're after that bank in your valley. I'm inviting myself in. I'm pulling that job with you.
You smell a lemon and old pea, Billy. Why don't you drag your ass up on a fork somewhere and eat your mush and let your grandchildren take care of you? What we got is beyond you.
You'll come to it. It's grizzled in your beard, too.
Finish your coffee and ride on out.
I ain't asking for a regular share. I'll take a half a share. I'll take less than that.
There ain't no job, there ain't no bank, and I ain't gonna tell you again.
I need a break. I've been down on my luck lately. Well, I even had to take a job to keep me eating. Pounding posts and stringing wire and shit like that.
Why can't we let him go with us, Mr. Spice?
Because I say.
I still don't see why not.
Because he's old, damn it. He's used up all his chances to be lucky.
I'm still a damn good gunfighter. I'll shoot. Let me fight this fella. I'll prove it to you. You just watch.
Wait a minute, I don't want to fight.
You'll be dead in a blink. Come on, boy, draw.
Mister, I'm not going to shoot with you.
You all think I'm an old rooster, but I can still go. I'll show you. I can still go.
Thank you.
Well, you killed him.
He was going after Todd.
Yes, he was. Hello. No man on this dodge ought to get out while he can. Because it don't hold up over a long stretch.
He was nearly as old as my grandfather. He had a safety pin holding up his pants.
Son, my foolishness in this life is misery. But we gotta hold ourselves together somehow. Or we'd always be crying. Better get some sleep. We're gonna hit that bank in the morning.
Sir?
A fine old American, Colonel Samuel Colt, and I'll take it all.
We'll sign the papers in the morning, boys.
It's a holdup! How is he?
Damn bad. I think it nicked his lung. Hey, you're shot up yourself. But some of this ought to keep you getting gangrene.
Well, it ain't enough.
I don't know why I like your boy so much. He was never noisy, never rude. A born gentleman by nature. Well, let's hope the ground that covers his grave will always be green.
He's not dead yet.
He's a guy. Say goodbye, Miss John.
He's still alive.
Put a hat over his face. He ain't gonna make it.
He's still breathing. Now we're gonna take him to a doctor.
Just load him on the horse will be his end.
We ain't leaving Todd behind!
That posse will be back. We're already short of horse. We won't make it unless we leave him.
And we won't make it.
I'd stay by his side if I thought it'd do him any good and me no harm. But that ain't the way it lies.
Don't you care nothing about him? You just said you did.
I've left men dead behind me. I've left men dying behind me. And I've left them calling my name. What you do is shut your ears and close your eyes and run like hell. You boys were older, have been at it longer. You know that's the only way to stay alive.
I sure got a taste of you now, Mr. Spikes.
I am not a follower of the meek and lowly Jesus. I never said I was. I hope to God you boys make it. You mean to shoot me? Is that why you have your gun out? My back is wide. You can't miss.
Easy. I'm making a blanket to cover him up. It's awful hot.
Yeah, I know, but I think that's what you're supposed to do.
Why don't he open his eyes?
He needs to bleed more.
Todd? Todd?
I'm gonna go get a doctor. We better switch pants because mine's got blood on it.
Why can't you go?
No, but this neck will be natural for me to ask. I'll just say I did it on a hay farm.
I hate seeing you take the risk.
It'll be just fine.
Ask a question, mister.
First, what are you drinking?
Well, what do you have?
Whiskey or beer? Here's one.
I don't have any.
It'll be 2 bits.
Is there a doctor around here?
What do you need a doctor for?
Well, I've got this cut here, and I want to get it patched up.
Oh, that little thing? That ain't nothing. Put some whiskey on it.
No, I'd rather have a doctor.
Well, there's a doctor in your body. Why don't you go there?
Well, I'm heading the other way.
Well, there's two brothers on a ranch that, 10 miles east of here. One of them studied to be a dentist. He fixes up cuts and whatnot.
Thank you, mister.
How'd you say you got that little scratch?
I did it on a hay fork.
Well, don't be in such a rush. Stay and have another drink.
No, I gotta get kicking.
Hell, I'm lying. Now, belly up.
I'd rather not.
Man can't stay for a free drink. Must be in a hell of a hurry. You must be in a powerful hurry.
No hurry, mister. I've just had enough.
That ain't friendly. Is it, Charlie? Suppose we sat on you and poured it down.
Mister, I treat people good if they treat me good. If they don't.
They had a doctor. They said there's some kind of dentist about 10 miles east of here. Maybe you can help us.
He's gone. Just stop breathing.
It's our fault. We're the ones that led him to it.
I told him it was going to be fine.
We're going to have to bury him.
Are you afraid of ghosts?
Ain't no ghost of his is going to bother me. I loved him.
Nice morning, ain't it? You got anything to eat?
He didn't think we'd pay. We must really look like bandits.
These folks around here are real nice and gentle, you know that?
Yeah, they are.
I could live around them and do just fine. We wouldn't need much. You don't look like he's got much. He smiled.
Well, after I get back from seeing Todd's folks, we'll see about it.
After you get back. We're both gonna go deliver that letter. I had a dream about us last night. We was both up on these great, big, fine-looking horses. We was barefoot. And we was riding through these blue mountains. Everything around us looked like it was just made that minute. You know, all the grass and the trees and the ferns and the woods and everything. I looked over at you and I said, Will, ain't it a grand life?
Proposition?
Yeah. I think it's a good one. He said if you don't like it, you can ride out
just like you wrote in. Nothing to lose. You can trust George. Why don't you give it a try?
Oh, I don't know, Billy.
Thanks, Harry.
Les, I've gone to deliver the letter to Todd's folks. I've got a long start on you, so don't try to follow me. Meet me in Piedras Negras 2 weeks from today, in that big Catholic church with the gold altar. Don't forget, there's a price on our heads, so don't get careless.
Hello, Sissy. Hello, Wilson.
Is your mom and dad home?
Gone to town.
For how long?
Till dark. You back from running away?
For a while.
Where you been to?
All around.
My daddy says you're trash.
What's up to him?
Didn't you bring Todd back?
No.
Why not?
You wouldn't recognize Todd, Sissy. He's doing so well. He's got all new clothes, and he's grown a head taller than me. He's as happy as can be.
His dog belongs to me now, and I ain't giving him back.
He wouldn't ask it to. He sent this letter. You see your mom and daddy get it.
I will. Want some lemon cake, Wilson? We got some.
I can't stay, Sissy.
You don't need that gun. You're Wilson Young?
I want to know who you are first, mister.
I'm Jack Bassett. Les sent me.
Why didn't he come himself?
That's what I'm going to tell you. You see, him and me, we got acquainted over to the hotel, and we've been kicking around together all week. He told me you'd be here tonight.
What's wrong with him?
I hate to be the one to tell you.
Just say if he's alive or not.
He was this morning. They got him over to the infirmary. He shot up awful bad. They got him while he was in his bed in the hotel. They hit him 4 times. I don't see how he's hung on this long.
Who did it?
There's two of them. They ain't even law. They're damn bounty hunters. One's named Morton and one's Spikes.
Who'd you say?
Morton.
No, the other one.
Spikes. What you figuring on doing, son?
I'm gonna get Les out of there.
Morton and Spikes is taking turns watching him. They got a chair parked right in front of the door to his room.
Did he ever come out?
Once in a while, breath of air.
That'll be enough. Which one's on now?
Morton. Spikes is sleeping over to the hotel.
Mister, could I ask you for a favor? Well, you done me one already, but could I ask you for another?
Sure, sir.
Could you go over to the hotel and keep an eye on Spikes for me?
I will. Don't you fight him fair.
cop where I can get a look at you. Who are you? Don't I know you?
No, no, sir, you don't.
What do you want around here?
Well, I don't want nothing.
Then move on.
Well, my sheepdog's run off from me. He's got a brown muzzle. You ain't seen him, have you?
I told you to move on.
Well, then maybe you see my friend. He lives in Yarrow County. I've known him all my life, and he's well-liked by everybody.
You're Wilson Young.
Train pulls out of here in half an hour. We're gonna be on it.
Maybe we'll go to Montana, to the Blue Mountains you was talking about. We'll find a place of our own to live. Maybe we can run some cattle and a few good horses. I can build a cabin and just sit up there on our own front porch. Mr. Morton down the street.
No loss.
You're next.
Well, that ain't decided yet.
I didn't come here to talk.
Funny how things work out. The governor of the state of Texas gave me a chance to come in. Full amnesty. For all my acts and crimes. As long as I deliver you to him. My hand and my pistol above first. And I said, I am giving you that which I have never allowed another living man to touch. Except myself. And he caught my hand. And they took my picture. And two ladies present wept.
Your gun's in the holster. You better sit up or you can't reach it.
I wanted to bring Leslie alive. I would have liked it better that way. But he pulled on me.
Is that the last thing you want to say to me? Because it ain't much.
Anything I ever got in this life was by following. I've been a hungry dog snapping at meat. And when you boys came along, you looked up to me. What did you want from me, anyhow?
I don't know anymore. It was a foolish hope.
Better luck next time.
Sit up, Mr. Spice.
You're a fine boy. If we'd met in a different life, we might have took a walk down a shady street and looked at the ladies through the window panes. Or I might have carved a Sunday roast. I'm giving you the biggest portion. But don't let me mix you up.
Sit up! Right there.